What for? My mother had to switch the baby from her right arm to her left so she could reach around my brother to stop me from laughing with a good twisting pinch on my arm. And that changed my laughter to crying, which made her even more mad, telling me that people were watching us create a scene. And she said, "Stop crying this instant, or you'll get what for when we get home." All the time she was talking, her lips were pursed, and my mother, staring straight ahead, turned into the family ventriloquist, and I was the dummy. I didn't want to get what for when I got home, so I took big gulps of air to try and stop my crying, and my mother reached across in front of my brother and pinched my leg, saying, "I told you to stop." But I couldn't, and she said, "Wait till I get you home, and I'll give you something to cry about." I never understood why laughing was bad and crying was better. And I didn't even try to stop crying. And people on the bus turned to see what was going on. And that infuriated my mother even more. And I saw her snake her arm behind my brother, heading towards my 4-year-old self. And I didn't want another pinching and another what for. So when the bus stopped, I ran out the back door, not caring where I was or where I was going. And I later realized I was going to get it again for not looking both ways before crossing the street, which I wasn't supposed to do without holding a hand. And the tears in my eyes kept me from seeing the car, even though I swore later that I looked both ways. And looking up at my mother from the hospital bed, she said, "Liar," without ever moving her lips.